Now let us try to solve some simple problems on circular motion. Remember, physics is simple. All problems in physics are simple if you know how to solve them. Right? If you don't know, then anything is difficult. So let's look at a very simple problem. A particle is moving in a circle. Right? And the speed is constant. And the speed is, say, 10 meter per second. Right? Speed of the particle is 10 meter per second. And the radius of the circle is 10 centimeter. And question is, what is the angular velocity? So how to solve this question? Speed is constant, and that is 10 meter per second. Radius is constant, that is 10 centimeter. What is omega? How to get omega from V and R? How? Simple, right? V equal to R omega. We have learned this. V is R omega, A is R alpha. That tangential acceleration, A is R alpha. So V is R omega, then omega will be V upon R. V is how much? 10. And what is the radius? 0.1 meter. Right? Convert that to SI. Don't leave it as 10. So what do you get? 100 radians per second. Problem done. Easy. V equal to R omega. Omega is V upon R. That's all. Right? Let's look at one more easy question. Suppose a particle is moving in a circle and the speed is continuously increasing. Now it is not UCM, right? And when we look at the particle, the initial speed is 5 meter per second. And finally the speed is, say, 6 meter per second. And this change takes place in 2 seconds. So moving faster, faster, faster. So at whenever you look at it, you find the speed is 5 meter per second. After 2 seconds, the speed has become 6 meter per second. And they are asking us find the angular acceleration alpha. So how do you get alpha? Alpha is A upon R. So we can use V equal to U plus AT and find A. And then find alpha by using alpha equal to A upon R. So what is that equation? V equal to U plus AT, right? This equation you know since your childhood, right? So we can find A. A will become V minus U by T. V is 6, U is 5, T is 2, and that gives us half 0.5 meter per second square. Right? Simple, V equal to U plus AT, everyone knows. And now we can find alpha by using alpha equal to A upon R, right? Omega is V upon R, A alpha is A upon R. These basic equations we should always remember. V equal to R omega and A equal to R alpha. This is tangential acceleration, the rate of change of speed. So alpha is A upon R. 0.5, what is the radius? Radius is not given here, so radius should be given. Radius is, say, 10 centimeter only. So radius is 0.1 meter. So we get this as 5 radian per second square. Suppose we don't like this method. We want to use the equation that you have learnt in circular motion. Then what will you do? You will use the rotational equivalent of this equation. In rotational motion, what does V become? V becomes omega. What does U become? Initial omega, that is omega naught. What does A become? Alpha. T remains T. Right? T does not change. So V becomes omega, U becomes omega naught, A becomes alpha. So omega equal to omega naught plus alpha t. So from here, actually, you can find out alpha. Alpha will be omega minus omega naught by T. Right? How to get omega? And omega naught? Omega will be V upon R. Omega naught will be U upon R. Right? So omega naught is U upon R. In this question, U is given as 5. R is 0.1. Right? So we get 50 radian per second as omega naught. And omega will be V upon R. V is 6 by 0.1, 60 radians per second. And now we put in this equation, omega is 60, U omega naught is 50, T is 2, so 60 minus 50 is 10, 10 by 2 gives us 5 rad per second square, exactly same answer. As long as we use correct physics, always we'll get the correct answer. Right? So what all things we learned from these two questions? First thing we learned was that omega is V upon R. Then we learned that E is R alpha. This A is tangential acceleration. So alpha is AT by R. And then we learn two equations, omega equal to omega naught plus alpha t. From here, we can get alpha directly, or we can use V equal to U plus AT. And from here, you get A. And then from A, you can always get alpha. Right? After solving questions, always try to note down the learnings separately so that you can revise it just before any exam, whatever be the exam. Learn the basics correctly. Here the basics are omega equal to V by R, alpha equal to AT by R, tangential acceleration by R, and equations, very easy equations, V equal to U plus AT, omega equal to omega naught plus alpha T.